Almost always, by the time the image gets to a monitor, it'll be in RGB format because that's the format that the monitors use. So colour spaces are a way of representing the colours in an image in a different way. And a lot of high definition video uses YCBCR. On the other hand, by the time the colours get to a printer, it'll be in CMYK format because that's the format that printers understand and that's the colour of their inks. RGB stands for red, green and blue, and apart from being the format we've talked about in the last few videos, it's also a format used by monitors. So if you want to show something on a screen, it's been basically put into RGB format. That's how much red have we got, how much blue have we got, and how much green have we got. When you add all colours together, you get different colours, and indeed, when you add all the colours together, you get white. Or if you take away all the colours, you get black. That's different to, let's say, the way that printers work, where if you add all the colours together, you get black, because if you keep adding colours in with your inks, you eventually get black. So if we draw a little RGB diagram here, so if this is red, and this is green, and this is blue, and halfway between blue and red will be magenta, between blue and green is cyan, and between red and green is yellow. And then between all three is white. And then outside of these, you've obviously got black. So you can create any colour you like on your monitor by varying the different amounts of these three colours. So on printers, it works slightly differently. So C, M, Y, and then K is black. But we don't tend to have K as part of this color. We'll use it to just create black effects because it works better. Halfway between C and M is blue. And then halfway between C and Y, we've got green. And then between magenta and yellow, we've got red. And in the middle of all of them, unlike RGB, we've got black here. So we're just gonna put K for black because we've already got blue. So this works in a completely different way to RGB. So it's additive. So the more dyes we add, the darker everything gets. And then we use K to actually just print in black if we want to.
So even though there's not a separate round circle there on your diagram for K, you would have a fourth ink.
Yeah, because in practice, what you might find is that if you try and add M, Y, and C together to get black, in principle it works, but you'll end up with a kind of muddy dark brown ink, which is just not as good as just printing in black, and you're wasting a lot of toner doing that. So just print in black. The last colour space we're going to look at is YCBCR. Variants of it are commonly used in TV broadcasting. So for example, PAL uses that colour space, NTSC uses a similar colour space but slightly different, and a lot of high definition video uses YCBCR. What we're trying to do with YCBCR is separate the luminosity of an image, so the intensity of each pixel, from the actual colour. And by doing that, we can do all kinds of clever things by downsampling the colour and things that we'll get onto when we talk a little bit about JPEG. This is a picture I took of a flower, okay? And this is currently in RGB form. And if we want to split this into YCBCR, what we need to do is take away the grayscale and the colour and separate them. This is just the luminosity component. So this is just Y. And that essentially is a grayscale version of the image. How bright is each pixel? And then we've also got the CB and the CR components. So CB represents the kind of the chrominance, the blueness of an image. So in this case, some of the flower in the middle is blue and the background is kind of blue, but the actual flower is quite yellow. And then the CR is the redness chrominance value. So how red is it? And you can see it's actually pretty red and the background is not very red at all.
So you mentioned the other one's sort of blue, but we're seeing obviously gray and yellow.
What I've done here is I've set the luminosity over the image to be flat at zero. And by doing that, the image isn't bright and it isn't dark, and we're just only seeing both CB and CR. So let me do a little bit of writing it down so you can see it better. Okay. When we would normally have RGB, instead we have YCBCR. So this is written this way. There's lots of variations on how you write this. So we usually use this prime symbol after the Y to represent that the RGB was gamma corrected. But we won't worry too much about that. For all intents and purposes, this is the luminosity, and these are the chrominance values. And this luminosity goes between 0 and 255, just like RGB. And the CB and CR are positions on a sort of a square, and they go from minus 127 to 128. It might be minus 128 to 127. Okay, so that's for CB and CR. And so what we essentially have is a cube like this, where our Y goes in this direction, and this is black down here, and this is white. And then our CB and CR are in these directions. So this will be CR, and this will be CB. And right in the center, where both of these values are zero, is gray. And our grayscale line is right down the center of this cube. And then up this direction, we'll get more and more red, and then less and less red down in this direction, and up in this direction we'll get more and more blue, and down we'll go less and less blue.
When you say less and less blue, you mean more yellow? Or?
In this case, yes. Although we call it blueness, actually also in this direction, the less blue it is, in a sense, the more yellow it is. But similarly with red, the less red it is, in general, the more green it is. But these colours only start to look realistic once you put them both back together again, and then combine them with the luminosity component.
So we've seen three different colour spaces and sort of roughly how they work. Why would you use one over another?
So in general, if you had a choice, you would use RGB because it's widely supported. It's what ends up needing to be output to a computer monitor, so graphics cards talk in RGB most of the time. If you're going to print anything, you're going to have to produce it into turn it into CMYK. Most of the print drivers will do this for you, so you don't need to worry about that. If you go into Windows or any other operating system and you print an RGB image, it will convert it to CMYK for you, and that will tell the printer how much ink it needs to use of the different colours. You would generally use YCBCR if you're doing any kind of TV broadcasting. So if you're actually sending a stream of data to someone's television, you need to worry about how much compression you have on that data, because it's quite important. And YCBCR lets you do very clever techniques by downsampling the colour components, but not downsampling the luminance component, and people won't really notice. And we'll talk about that when we talk about JPEG. I should say, it's this fundamental to how JPEG works, is downsampling of the colour components.
We'd like to thank Harrys.com for sponsoring this Computerphile video. They're a subscription shaving service. So if you go to Harrys.com, check out some of the products, they'll deliver them right to your door. I've been using Harry's products for a while now. They've recently sent me this chrome razor, which is really, really cool. All the products are really, really nicely packaged. And I've also been using the foaming shave gel and this aftershave lotion. And if you've got skin that's not so good like mine, you'll find these make a really, really nice job of it. So check out Harrys.com, the subscription shaving service. If you use the coupon code Computerphile, you'll get $5 off. So thanks once again to Harry's for sponsoring this Computerphile video.
So JPEG works by downsampling the colour components and using other techniques as well. The majority of video compression methods will do the same thing.
So you're being compressed right now, by
I certainly am, yes.